Hello, I'm Faust from Erkenbrand, and I'm here for Red Ice TV. I'm at the IJzerwaken here today, which is a Flemish nationalist festival. It's pan-Dutch, so there's Dutch attending, there's Flemish attending. I've been told that today there are so far 3,557 people. It's a huge annual event to celebrate Flemish nationalism, Dutch internationalism. It's a very identitarian focused festival. I'm here with some 20 guys from Erkenbrand, and we hope you enjoy our coverage. I'm here with
Maarten de Boek. I'm a representative of VNJ, Vlaams Nationaal Jeugdfront, the Flemish Nationalist Youth Organization.
The bands that you saw playing and a lot of the children and the playing here is all members of your organization, as I understand it.
Well, all the young children, definitely the ones wearing green jerseys, blue jerseys, are the ones from our youth organization. But also among the other people, you will find a lot of former members from our organization. We exist since 1961, so that's already 56 years now. There have been difficulties in the past, definitely. 10, 15 years ago, when Vlaams Blok was very big party, well, all our children immediately got labeled. We want, of course, to be Flemish nationalists, but we don't want the children already to have a label of a political party on them. These young people are coming together and they're forming Bonds for Life, who work together the entire organization for life.
To be honest, I am finally a dissident in the Catholic Church. But because in the Catholic Church there's a big problem. There has been an infiltration by secret societies who want to the world government and world install world tyranny, and they must control the Catholic Church. They have infiltrated the Church, but because the Church has a divine promise to survive, it is between brackets the only entity in the universe that has a divine promise of survival. I am faithful to the roots of the Catholic Church, and so I'm in conflict with the infiltrators who focused the top of the Church.
So how do you think the current Church leadership and the Pope would look at events, nationalist events like the IJzerwaken, which for our viewers, IJzerwaken translates to Iron Mass or Wake of Iron. It is a Church service remembering soldiers.
Yes. It is a Church service, but it is referring to the soldiers who died in the First World War, Flemish soldiers who wanted to continue their culture and their language and their faith, and they were thinking about what are we fighting for, because we are fighting against the Germans, but for the Belgian Republic. But the Belgian Republic is Freemason. In our own country, we claim the right to speak our own language, to live our own culture, and to keep our own faith.
To basically keep your own identity.
Lieve Nederland getrouwd, die boskrik van Spanje. Mijn Batavisch gemoed wil betuigen door mijn bloed en mijn jonge leven voor haar vrijheid geven.
We're an association that invites students to learn more about our heritage. We're nationalists, so we're giving courses in what is it to be a nationalist, what is our heritage from Flanders. What's about in geopolitics, for example. We also do actions. If there's
demonstrations?
Yeah, demonstrations. Every year we have a big demonstration in one of our student cities in Flanders. We have also some smaller actions, for example, against illegals that are doing hunger strikes in universities or in churches even.
Yes.
Or if the King of Belgium wants a bigger allowance, then we're also protesting against that because we're against the monarchy here in Belgium. We're for the Flemish Republic.
We just did an interview with the NSV earlier, and now we'd like to talk about Voorpost. Tell us something about your organization.
Voorpost is een heel Nederlandse actiegroep. Wij willen Nederland en Vlaanderen herenigen. En we hebben een afdeling in Zuid-Afrika. Onze militanten die zijn hier vandaag om de boel te beveiligen. Service te verlenen aan mensen die slecht ter been zijn. Wij organiseren scholingsbijeenkomsten. Wij organiseren kameraadschapsavonden. Maar het belangrijkste is en blijft onze actieafdeling. Wij voeren acties om druk te zetten op de politiek. Of om de bevolking te mobiliseren voor of tegen bepaalde thema's. De laatste 2-3 jaar hebben we een aanwas van nieuwe militanten, nieuwe leden. En dat komt vooral omdat er de laatste jaren heel veel aandacht is voor de toestroom van gelukzoekers. Mm-hmm. Die dan in de meest kleine dorpen in Nederland gepropt worden. En waar de mensen niet op zitten te wachten. Je ziet ook dat er bij jongeren ook een groter besef is van de afkomst. Dat je behoort tot een volk, dat je geboren wordt uit de vader en de moeder die ook weer een ver voorgeslacht hebben. En mensen willen dat in stand houden en daar is Voorpost mee bezig.
Many people think Flanders is only something of the First World War or is something which is only a little dot on the map, especially if you're from USA. But it's also a point or a place in Europe with great problems, even bigger problems than in other regions, I think, in Europe.
Identity issues, Wallonians versus Flemish.
Yes, but also if one sees the mass migration that is coming, Brussels, Molenbeek, I don't have to say, it's evident. Yes. That I think if you look towards other countries in Europe, that Brussels is one of the biggest hellholes that exists. Because if I go to Brussels is our capital. But there is no one that speaks Flemish in Brussels.
I can
or
agree.
Either they speak French or they speak Arab.
I have to say, I arrived in Antwerp this morning and I've been in Brussels in the past. The first thing I saw is armed soldiers at the train station. The second thing I saw was Orthodox Jews.
Yeah, that's like it. And our government is doing nothing against it. They're putting soldiers and they're saying, we've put soldiers, but you're going to have to live with terrorism. That's part and parcel of a big city.
But do you think that with recent developments, as you said, the church leadership is gone, do you think with recent developments that this sort of festivals are recharacterized because, you know, Islam is invading, and do you think the old identitarian questions are still relevant, or do we have new identitarian questions that need to be solved first?
Yes, of course, there's now a bigger problem. That is, concretely, we face now the Islamic invasion. But this Islamic invasion has been finally organized by our governments.
Yes.
Because the governments opened the frontiers. So it is our own leadership that is the cause of the problem, not the Islam, the Islamists, not themselves.
Yes.
But they have been invited to come here, and they are paid, and they have a good life here. And therefore they are here. So I don't blame them as aspect. But the people who are really guilty is our own government.
Yes.
And our government is tired by forces behind the curtains. Yeah. Because the government has, impayable debt to the banks.
Yes.
And so the bankers are ruling the world. And the bankers are these same people who want to install their government all over the world. And therefore they want to control the church, and they want the Islam to come in our countries to destroy Christianity and the Catholic Church.
Een groene postchristelijke linkerzijde van cultuurmarxisten in Vlaanderen, het rode kameradenprofitariaat van de PS in Wallonië en rond de kringen van het industriële complex opgebouwd sinds Leopold II, het Hof in Brussel. Het Hof, de spin in het web. Het instituut dat Vlaanderen en Wallonië vanuit Brussel tot een wingewest gemaakt heeft en België tot wat het nu is, a failed state. Ons onderwijs werd door de 68-taars ingeschakeld om de jeugd te hersenspoelen, te indoctrineren, kritisch denken af te leren en tot volgzame werkkrachten te modelleren. Brood en spelen. Meer moet dat niet zijn voor de gelovers in de maakbaarheid van de mens. Onze politici dwingen ons via vakkundig opgestelde wetten en speciaal opgerichte instellingen tot dimitude, de aanvaarding van en de onderwerping aan de volgelingen van een totalitaire religie. Een nu nog net minderheid die onder het mom van demografische noodzaak, solidariteit en liefdadigheid en masse wordt geïmporteerd. Deze migratie is misdadig.
So you think that mixing it all into one globalized world population is not Catholic?
No, not at all. It is lessening the glory of God. Okay. Because the glory of God, when you go to a zoo and you see only one species of animal, even when it is a marvelous animal like a lion, it is boring after some time.
So multiculturalism.
The marvel of a zoo is the variety of animals. The marvel of a park is the variety of plants. So the marvel of human world is a variety of civilizations, of people, cultures. Yes, and that makes it, and we respect each other. Yes. But everybody, St. Thomas said that every nation has its own genius. So let's develop our genius, and so it is worthwhile to go to Japan. But when everywhere where we go, we find McDonald's and Coca-Cola in this, that it is boring, you see.
Yes. So multiculturalism is an affront to God.
Multiculturalism, in that sense, that it is mixing up everything, it is lessening the beauty of humanity, of course. Okay. But when multiculturalism is in that way that we respect each culture and that we respect each other, that we consider, dan is this marvelous.
De grenzen moeten dicht. Zoveel is duidelijk. De massale immigratie heeft ondertussen grote groepen vreemdelingen in onze samenleving gebracht. Jarenlang heeft de politieke elite de multiculturele wonden laten etteren. Assimilatie. Het overnemen van onze cultuur, het overnemen van onze kernnormen en waarden is de enige oplossing om de ontspoorde multiculturele nachtmerrie nog enigszins in de hand te houden.